That's it, mate, that's it. Just go, ah. Okay, now breathe in. Breathe out again. Okay, just say ah. Just open your mouth and say ah again. Yeah, you're not well there, mate. Oh, hi, good morning. Hi, sorry about this. Nev's been up all night, bless him. He's got a bit of a fever and he's got a bit of an upset tummy, haven't you?
Sniffy nose.
You have got a sniffy nose, yeah. Blow. Harder. That's it, okay.
Oops.
Now, don't blow from that one.
Sorry, Barney.
Let's just get that going for now. There we go, that's all right. So,
can't smell.
No, well, you know, that's part of the thing. It's when you get a cold, you can't smell. But I can smell it. Believe me, you don't want to be able to smell right now.
No fun.
You feeling all right, mate?
Poorly.
I know you're poorly. Listen, don't worry about it, right? I can do the show today, so you lie back in bed and relax.
Soup, please.
You want some soup?
Yeah.
You're really not well, are you? You normally have jam. Well, what sort of soup? I'll tell you what, my grandma gives me chicken soup when I'm not feeling well. That works a treat.
Jam soup.
You want jam soup?
Yeah.
Is that not just jam warmed up, though?
Mate,
you've kind of overdone it on the jam a little bit this week.
Jam soup, please.
You want jam soup? That'll make you feel better. Yeah. Okay, well, listen, I'll start getting that prepared. Let's watch Arthur in the meantime, shall
okay.
we? That'll cheer you up. You know what the doctor always says?
What?
A good dose of Arthur keeps the cold away. He doesn't really say that, but, you know, it works for now.
Confused.
Press the button.
There, please.
It's all right, mate, I'll sort it out. There you go, that's it. Swallow it down. How's that? Okay? Let me get that bit on your chin. There you go. How's that feel?
Yum, yum.
Better?
More jam soup, please.
Well, I think you've had enough for now. Aye, we've made his jam soup. No, you've had enough, mate, because, you know, my grandma used to say, you starve a fever, feed a cold. Feed a cold. What was it?
Feed bear and starve beaver.
You feed a bear and starve a beaver.
Yeah.
I don't think that's what it
feed
is.
Bear,
that won't help
please.
You cold. If anything, you should feed the beaver, to be honest. It's just cruel otherwise, isn't it? You can't starve beavers. That's not on. How did you get the bug anyway? I can't work out how you got it. I feel fine. You know, Ducky seems to be okay. Kirsten hasn't been ill since 1962. You know?
Bear flu.
You've got the bear flu?
Yeah.
You have got all the symptoms of bear flu, actually, yeah. But you haven't been around other bears, though, have you?
I don't know.
You mean to tell me that there could be sort of loads of roving grizzlies hiding behind little tiny pots? Now you've said it. Mate, as soon as I mentioned the word grizzly, there was a knock on the wardrobe door. Only grizzly monsters knock on the wardrobe door at this time of the morning.
No.
I think we should find out, though, just to be sure.
Oh, no.
Don't be too scared, it's OK. I know you're not feeling so good, but I'll look after you. Unless he's massive, in which case I'm legging it.
Barney! Help!
Excuse me, are you a roving grizzly bear who hides behind pots of jam who's come to eat me and my friend?
No, I'm Sam and I like scaring blue bears.
It's Sam! Oh. Sam, it's such a relief to see you. How are you doing?
Hello, Sam.
Right?
Yeah.
Welcome to the show. Want to say hello to Nev?
Hello, Nev.
Hello.
So, you can give him a kiss if you want to. Although I would wash that thoreughly afterwards.
Oh,
we've got
yum,
a present.
Prezi.
Nice, have a look at that.
Barney.
What is it?
Yum,
it's a bit
yum.
Of fudge.
Top.
You don't like fudge, though. No, you don't. No, it's
Barney.
No, it's not toffee, it's fudge.
No,
yeah,
it's mine.
No, because you like toffee.
Barney.
You don't like fudge. No, that says fudge. Across the
bottom.
So if I just put
Sam.
This over here somewhere so that only I can reach it.
Oh.
Lovely.
Mine.
Sam. Thank you very much. Now, listen, you've written a nightmare story for Nev. The idea is to keep him awake throughout the show because he keeps falling
asleep. Can't scare me!
Well, having said that, it's a bit cruel this morning because he's not feeling so good, so we've got to go easy, OK? That's OK. Shut up. Now, you've drawn some pictures. They're pretty scary too.
Mm-hmm.
Are you ready for this? Have you got the right page?
Yeah.
OK, then. It's now time to give Nev nightmares! That's actually his laugh.
One night, Nev was cozy in bed when suddenly the wardrobe made a bump. Nev hid under his covers when he heard something say, "I'm hungry, I want scrambled Nev." Nev jumped out from under his bed and got Ducky and his torch. He had goosebumps all over. Bye. thump, the wardrobe door creaked open a tiny bit. Nev closed his eyes and placed his hand on the handle and opened it. Phew! Sighed Nev. There's only his blue ducky inside. Ah, oh, my tummy is rumbling, said the voice again. Nev jumped and spun round quickly. Who are you? Shouted Nev. My name is Ploops, and I'm going to eat you all up! Ploops crawled out from under Nev's bed. Ploops took Nev down to the kitchen and put Nev into a pie tin with extra crusty pastry. And he shoved the very scared Nev into the oven. Nev was never to be seen again. But one day, Barney discovered a very strange-looking pie left in their kitchen. The end.
What was in the pie? Sam, it's time to ask the big question.
Nev, how are you feeling?
Frightened.
He's back. Brilliant. Sam, well done, mate. That was a fantastic story. As a thank you from me, I've got your little prezi, so go under the bed at that side and you'll find it. Be very careful, though, because Bandit the cat is under there. You can hear him. So I've got him this week's copy of Meow Magazine. It's his favourite read. Yeah, Bandit, have a look on page 6. There's a very informative article on how to wee in your master's shoes more effectively. OK.
Bed.
He's got it. He's distracted. Quick, get your prizes. Quick. Quick, before he... OK, I'll get that one. Oh, wow, there's loads. There should be about 6 in there, I think. I'm really happy you did the story. Quick!
Stuck!
Nice! Bed, buddy, that'll do. Oh, sorry. You okay? I took you out there by smacking in the end. There you go, Ben 10 figures, all action figures, and you've got your stuff there as well that you can play with at the front. It's like an action lair. How cool is that?
Cool.
Would you be even happier if you could put Jakers on as well, so that you can have time to play with
piggies!
All right, then let me get the remote control for you.
Piggies, please!
Yeah, we're doing it now, don't we?
I'll tell
you what, we'll get the old soup out as well, because it's all about bugs this week in Jake's, you see, and they've got a bit of
gem soup, please.
So maybe we'll find a bit of a cure, but not in there just yet. Sam, there's the remote. Press the button. Here's Jake. Steady on, steady on, mate. Take it easy. Mate, listen, I know you want to get involved, but you can't do monkey impressions when you're not very well, mate. Hey, all right, listen. Listen, you've got to take it easy, OK? You're not feeling any better, are you?
I'm sick. Poorly.
Do you know what? I'm gonna call somebody here. Just excuse me one second, people. I'm just gonna call the emergency services. Hang on. They'll know what to do. They have that doctor line where you can tell them about stuff. Hi, is that the doctor place where you can tell me what's wrong with people? Hiya.
Yeah.
Listen. Hey. I've got a blue bear, right? And he's not feeling very good. He's been up all night. He's got a bit of a temperature. That's him. Yeah, he's coughing. He has got stomach cramps. Yeah. Well, I didn't want to use medicine because he said he likes, you know, like jam. So I made him some jam soup because I used to have soup when I was younger. And it made me feel better. So I made him some jam soup, but that hasn't helped either.
Yum yum.
Do you reckon? Okay. Well, it kind of is an emergency, really. So I mean, could you send somebody round? Well, straight away. That'd be great. Thanks.
Hi, Bonnie.
That was quick. Thank you very much. You got new takeaways as well, do you? I'll have the lamb booner and chapati. Cheers. All right, see you in a bit. Thanks, guys. Thank you. So you're here to have a look at Nev, yeah? Great.
Let me see. Oh, that's way above normal.
Really? Oh, temperature. Hold still.
108 degrees. That's quite a turnaround.
It's hot.
How many fingers am I holding up?
9. No. 6. 4. I don't know.
Oh dear.
Oops.
It's just as I thought.
What's just as you thought? What's just as you thought? What is it?
It's not good.
What?
It's an allergy to jam.
You okay? It's an actual allergy to jam, which means you can't have jam anymore.
No.
Nev, I'm sorry. We can't. No more jam. The doctors have said. You're never going to eat jam ever again.
No jam.
Oh, Nev, don't. I'm really sorry about this. Listen, can you get yourselves ready for Nev's pyjamas? I'll play with you after that. We'll game. Thanks for that, guys. Cheers.
Oh, Bernie.
Nev, no jam. I know, but you know, it's for the best, mate, you know, because it makes you not well.
It's sad.
I know you're sad.
Miss Jam.
Well, you can always have fruit and vegetables or something instead, can't you?
Oh, icky.
Are you reminiscing about Jam?
Yeah.
Is that what you're doing?
Jam. Jam. Yummy. Jam. Love jam.
I know it's quite sad, you know, because it's your favourite thing in the whole wide world, but what about fruit and veg? They're healthy.
Icky.
Well, you can still sniff your socks.
And can't work. Smell.
You can't smell. Oh, because you've got a cold, of course. What about ice cream? You like ice cream, don't you?
Ice cream.
Yeah.
Ice cream.
That's not what I meant. I meant the stuff that's made out of cream and ice. Ice cream.
Yum, yum. Yeah.
So you can still have that. You don't need to have jam with it, do you?
Ice cream soup, please.
Yeah? So.
Ice cream soup, please.
Ice cream soup?
Yeah.
I think I can make you some ice cream soup. I think that's doable. Would that make you feel better?
Yeah.
Okay, how about watching Jakers as well? Would that make you feel better?
Piggies!
You want some more piggies? Piggies and ice cream. It's a good mixture. Okay.
Groovy.
Jeff, stop playing the piano now, mate. He's happy. Cheers, fella. All right, then. Ready for this? Press the button. Here's the button.
Piggies!
Wow, so the fairies turned Fernie into a flea. That's pretty cool. I wonder if they'll turn Dallin into a duck, or maybe Piggly into a pig. Oh, hang on a minute. Piggly is a pig, and Dallin is a duck. That's not going to happen, is it? Oh, hello. You're looking better. How you feeling? All right?
Yeah, groovy. Scream soup, much better.
Ice cream soup. Yeah, we've given him some ice cream soup this morning. It's made him feel loads better.
Yeah.
It's worked really quickly as well, hasn't it?
Jam, please.
No, jam.
Why?
You're on a strict diet now, mate. You know because you're allergic to jam. The doctor's told you before.
Never mind.
Listen, you can't have jam, okay?
But
don't be touching anything. Oi.
Not me, ducky. Quack.
It's not you, it's the ducky. Just because you've got a ducky dressing gown on doesn't mean I'm going to fall for that one.
Yeah.
Nev, I can see you.
Yeah.
Do you know what? Let's have a look at what's still to come on Smile, shall we, today, while he gets himself sorted out. We've got BB3 before you. It's back! You know you like that. And we've also got Even Stevens. Great show. Just to see that perm one more time doing its thing. Right then. Of course, we are playing Lost Properly a bit later. We're very excited about that. But now we're playing an even more fun game. That's got jam in it. Are you going to be okay with this?
Jammers!
Come out in a rash. I'm not putting cream on it, all right? Yum, it's time to play. Yes, it's Nev's pyjamas. There are pies. Nev, seriously, jam. You're not going to be well, mate. Let's get Sam in. Sam, in you come, mate. Sam's playing pyjamas today. How you doing, fella?
Fine.
Face
Hello,
front.
Sam.
Behave yourself.
Hello.
Okay, you've already met Nev, of course, in Nev's Nightmares. Let's talk about your skill as a pyjamas player. Do you have much experience?
Well, I went to pyjamas college.
Pyjamas college. Okay, so did you come away with a first in that?
Yeah.
An expert in the game. Well, let's get the topics you're answering today. In they come.
Hi, Barney. I'm Marina, and I've got animals.
Hi, Marina. Oh, my giddy aunt. Didn't expect that.
Frightened.
Thanks for that. Animals. Animals are purple.
Hi, Barney. I'm Kezia, and I've got showbiz.
Have you got showbiz? Do a little spin, darling. Ah, look at that. Fabulous. There's your showbiz topic right there. Ting. I like the tingy bit.
Hi, I'm Jack, and I've got sport.
Hi, Jack. He's got sport. Look. Next up.
Hi, Barney. I'm Nathan. I've got the questions for all of us, mate.
Beautiful. Cheers for that, Nathan. Questions by Jack, Kezia, Nathan and Marina. Now, Sam, which topic would you like to choose? It's your choice, completely your choice. You don't have to choose any topic in particular. You know, it's entirely to you which topic you choose, which one would you like to go for.
Questions.
You will!
Brilliant!
Well played, fam. Sam, you are going to have 60 seconds to answer as many of these questions as you can. If you get one right, Nev will do this. It's a whack-whack on the bot. You're going to throw a pie in the air and it's going to land in these pyjamas, but they are no ordinary pyjamas, are they? What are they?
Pyjamas!
Absolutely enormous underwear made in Rotherham in 1962. Oh, Kirsten O'Brien. Very nice. So, I'm now going to take my position once I pick the cards up. Sam, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, your time starts now. England is part of the UK. True or false?
True.
Throw the pie. Whoa! A bit harder. You can move closer if you want to, guys. Girls Aloud released their first single last year. True or false?
False.
First single was 2002. That's in there. Purple and green, when mixed together, make blue. True or false?
True.
It's false. The longest day each year is July the 21st. True or false?
False.
Not a pie. Don't forget, if you get 5 pies, you're getting some Nev's PJs. Adult cows drink milk. True or false?
False,
they produce milk. Not a pie. Good shot. Turtles can swim. True or false?
False. No. True.
Not a pie. Good shot. Pizza originates from Jamaica. True or false?
False.
Not a pie. Get it in there. Postman Pat has a cat called Teddy. True or false?
False.
It's Jess. Not a pie. Oh, it's nearly going in there. Mount Kinabalu is a mountain in Southeast Asia. True or false?
False.
It's true. Throw the pie anyway. Quick. Good shot. Yes. I think we're out of time. We've got 1 second left. OK, Sam, well done. How many pies did we get in there, fellas?
I don't have a clue.
One, two. There's three there, isn't there? Now, it was 5 to get some Nev's PJs, Sam. But I can give you the option now to try and redeem yourself a little bit, OK? This is a mud pie, just like in the game that you play on the computer. We're now going to get some lights, some tension music, and I'm going to give you a countdown. If that mud pie hits somebody square in the face, Jack, come a bit closer, everybody... everybody goes away with Nev's PJs. OK, are you ready? Now, we're all going to give you a 3-2-1. Is that OK, guys, yeah? In 3, 2, 1! Throw the pie! On your head! Yes! What a great shot! What a fantastic shot. Sam, what a legend. Well played, mate. We've actually got an action replay at the moment. Sam redeemed it for the boys and the girls and got everyone Nev's PJs. Take a look at this. Look at that.
Yeah, yeah.
So Zinedine Zidane, that's known as, in pyjamas. So that means everyone's got PJs. Well done. Now, though, it's time for BB3B. Sam, I'm going to give you one more chance to be a cool TV presenter. All you've got to do is look straight down that camera and say, it's now time for BB3B and it's a bit whiffy.
It's now time for BB3B and it's a bit whiffy.
It's a legend.
Groovy!
Do you know what? I'm not sure I could live with all those smells. That'd be awful, wouldn't it? Right on cue. Are you joking? Mate, don't sniff it.
Lovely two jams.
What do you mean, lovely two jams? Oh, oh yes, the jam thing. Should we talk about that for a second, shall we? We found out this morning that Nev's got an allergy to jam. He can't eat jam without doing what he just did. And so we've had him on an ice cream soup diet all morning, which has been working fine until we played pyjamas about 10 minutes ago.
Yeah, yeah.
He ate some of the jam and now he's a bit windy pops.
Oops.
No, you can't go testing the wind like that. That's disgraceful.
Oh, icky.
Well, you will feel icky.
It's morning. Morning.
Oh, morning.
What? The dead sausage is that stench.
It's gross, isn't it?
Is that you?
It's not me. No. There's your answer.
Oh, Nev!
Nev's got a jam allergy.
Oh.
And unfortunately, that's the effect it has.
Well, sorry. Well, listen. Well, yeah, you might be a little bit ill, but are you sure it doesn't need a special moment as well?
The moment of movement.
Yes.
Yes, he might need one of those. Do you want to go for one of those?
Okay.
Okay.
Bye.
Oh. maybe I have two.
Oh, dear.
I tell you what, make a bowl of ice cream soup and sit on it. We'll cool that down a little bit.
The costumes here in the studio and move away from the smell.
Yeah.
Move away and hope it doesn't travel with us.
Wowzers.
Hi, guys. right, we're going to give you 10 seconds each to tell us, because we'll make the decision, shall we, why you should get your very own Nev Bear. Are you set? Are you ready? You're going first, and your 10 seconds starts now!
I got a medical box because I'm a doctor and the guy with that, and I'm a stethoscope out of something for and a candle holder. I've got a reflex thing, and I've got a torch to look into someone's mouth, and I've got my bag.
Very good.
Ooh, I like that. That's a really good thing, little thing, that, isn't it?
Get it, Jack, you're
very right. Inventive, cool, OK, nice work. Next up.
Kezia.
Go!
I got my dad's shirt, I made a watch, I got a pen, I made my hat out of carding paper and drew a medical sign on it.
Bang on 10 seconds, well done. Jackie, sure go, you ready? Go!
I got a shirt and I drew some fake blood on it and a cross and my name and I've got a stethoscope and some trousers.
Some trousers? Good job.
And that's staying on the front, that's jam, yes?
No.
Let's carry on then. Nathan? 10 seconds starts now.
Well, my dad works in the hospital, so he borrowed some stuff, and basically we got this, put some blood in it, and me and Jack made it together, and it says Jack Gibbons Law on the back of my trousers.
OK, good.
You see, when you're wearing one of those gowns, aren't you supposed to not have any trousers on, and then when you walk up the corridor...
That's true.
Sam, last but not least, 10 seconds, go for it!
I used a torch from my head.
And I used the CD from a Hedgehog, and I made this name badge, and I made the stethoscope, I have a coat hanger and a plug, and I got a football sock and attached a duck to it.
I like the randomness of that. What are we going to do?
I don't know. It's a tight one this week, isn't it?
This is really troublesome.
This is one for the dads, really, isn't it? They should decide, because they know all about that.
They should.
Maybe
I've
we should.
I've got a trapped sneeze, actually. I might sneeze in your face. Yeah, I'm sorry.
That's wait.
Right.
Oh, sneeze.
No, no,
go
I think
it is. Why are you just going like... They know we're not whispering to each other.
All right. What do you think? I'm Pisces and I can't make decisions. My fish swim in opposite directions.
A lot of rubbish.
What are you going to go for? Come on, there's a few more cartoons to wedge in on the show this morning.
Five over. I think we should go four.
You're not saying anything. Really?
Yeah.
OK, I'm going with
should
you.
Go for that?
Yes.
OK, this is Kirsten's idea, everyone.
We decided to go for...
Sam! Well done, mate. You got yourself your very own.
Very well done.
See, and he's got MD on his coat there. That stands for My Ducky.
All
right, well done. Thank you
good
to everybody.
Stuff.
Thank you to everybody dressed up. You're all looking lovely.
We're going to see you a little bit later on as well this
morning
for more games and stuff. And thanks very much, everyone, dressing up last week. Looking cool. There's trophies and medals and certificates. I'm going to start here with Nick Baker just kissing his medal there. He's got all the glory and very nice as well, crown there.
I like this in the middle, Hannah. I don't know what that is. It's like a massive rosette, isn't it?
Oh, it is, isn't it? Yeah.
It's huge.
Maybe she rides an enormous horse.
Maybe.
Massive horse. I like Rory's certificate. Here, look at that, just peeking through. For watching Smile every Sunday morning, that's why he's been awarded that.
James and Rebecca here with their two big ones. Look, you've got a trophy there and a lovely plaque here, showing them off as if they're proud.
Excellent.
Very nice. Thank you very much, guys,
yes,
for getting in touch.
Good work,
brilliant.
Everyone. Fancy a cartoon?
What if I say no? Because I know it's next, you see. Should we just do it anyway?
Yeah.
It's time for BB3B. More smelliness. The old BB3B, we're loving it.
Nev, are you feeling better now?
Yeah, yeah!
Oh, yeah. That ice cream soup really worked a treat, you know?
Quack, quack.
It worked really well, didn't it? You're feeling so much better.
Yum, yum!
Well, while Barney brings himself back down to earth, let's take a look at what happens on Smile in the next 20 minutes or so. Do I do this?
Yes.
Go on, then.
I shall do this. I shall talk you through it. We're playing a little bit of Lost Properly in just a bit.
Lost
and
Properly.
Then quick on the draw!
Quick on the draw!
After that, Stevens de la Evens, as they call it on the continent. And then we should be playing games, some more games, and a few more games.
Yeah.
After that. And right now, it's time to rumble and jumble.
See, it's very odd. If you're going to push me, it's obvious. The chair doesn't move. Look, it's this pat on the camera. He's doing the shape thing. Should we do it again?
You're such a spoil sport.
Let's join in again. And it's time to
rumble
and jumble.
It's
been attacked by a Klingon.
So last week, five letters appeared on your screen. They were in a random order. It was your job to jumble and make them into a word and draw a picture. These are the letters as they appeared on your screen last week. Someone made the word...
You're purrit.
Oh, it's six letters, actually. Yeah, six.
No!
Which actually made the word trophy, because you're isn't a word.
Wow, have you done a you're purrit?
Yeah, yeah. Look.
That's very good, you're purrit.
That one are
you're purrit.
You do, you do.
Oh, that's funny, because I actually thought that was a pyre hot.
Is that not a pyre hot?
I'm confused.
You've done it again, haven't you?
Hot.
Is that a pyre hot? It's a hot pie.
Confused.
Okay.
Well, lots of you to draw pictures of trophies. Have a look at lots of your pictures. This is some of the stuff we got sent through the post. It's great, isn't it? Shiny trophies, big trophies, little trophies. Them trophies. Look at that!
I will!
Like
a
that.
Whole trophy cabinet!
That's actually my cabinet at home, that is.
It's
an inside. I won one for playing darts, one for making jam sandwiches, and one for putting peas on a cake. It was a happy birthday cake, it was the two peas in the middle. But they just thought it was ingenious. And moving on, Nev with movable arms, we like that. Look, number one jambuster player. Well, we've got some jambusting going on a bit later.
I tell you what, I bet there's a tinfoil shortage in the supermarkets now. There'll be none left, will there, if anyone's baking a cake. We have picked some winners as well. Special mention, shall we start with that one?
Yeah, we should actually, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, let's start with it.
Go on then.
Of course, there are various words you can make out of the letters that you had, and one of those words was Python. It's not right, but it's good. Look, it's a python made out of cups.
Groovy.
How brilliant is that? It's sent in by... Where's the letter? Meg Jones! I made this glittery snake out of plastic cups. I hope you like it. Yeah, yeah, she's written down. There you go, Nev. Give her a yeah.
Yeah, yeah!
Very good.
Love
Thank you.
You
for that.
Thank you, indeed. Love the you. People we're going to give T-shirts to, though, are Holly Clark, who's done this amazing trophy here. Look at that,
there
10
I
years
am.
Old. Brilliant. Isn't it great? Your
That's
face.
10 years old. It's me.
Looks so face. Lifelike. I'm going to put it next to your face so you can tell the difference. Well,
trophy head.
That's great work, Holly. Well done.
Very nice. This has been sent in by Chloe. And Chloe has done. She's made her own little trophy out of that moulding clay stuff. Look at this.
Small.
The proper trophy, look. And it's got Neb on the front as well. Can you get even closer? There we go, look at that. Oh,
that
focus was great on that
really
one.
Good.
You see on the bottom there, there's a little star as well.
Small Neb.
Lovely. I like
Chloe.
That one.
Beautiful.
Love you.
This one is from Beatrix, who's 8 from Wales, actually spelling her name Bear. Beatrix,
oh,
I like,
nice.
So special bear. And look at that. On the front it says, Best Bear. It must be a trophy specially for you, Neb. You have
I
won
win.
It for being the best bear. Well done to you.
Very nice.
Love you.
This one here.
Wow.
I wonder if is that the letter inside, do you think? Oh, no, it's on the back. Lauren. Lauren has sent in a Neff trophy. She's made it out of cardboard and put one of those cocktail things in there in the middle to hold it in place. Looks very groovy and cool. Again, the tinfoil gets used for the shiny stuff. Very nice.
And Daniel, who is in Essex, I've got the last one here. It's a very nice felt Neff peeping out of a gold trophy there. Which is lovely, isn't it? Well done, everyone. You've got yourself some
groovy.
T-shirts.
Spot
on. You know, you're a bit poorly. I've got a bit of a treat for you now. How do you fancy seeing one of your favourite little chefs?
Oh, yum, yum!
The one where you make homemade jam?
Oh, yeah.
That'd be very jam. Exciting. Let's catch up with Rhiannon and Leah.
You stink.
Stinky bear.
Today we're going to be making Nev's favourite. Nev, what are we going to be making?
Jam!
Yay!
Please, jam, please.
So what are we going to need today, Leah?
Jam.
Well, we're going to need...
Jam.
Yeah, we're going to be making jam.
Mm,
OK. Jam. We're going to need honey.
Yum, yum.
Lemon juice. Mm. Some mixed berries.
Mm.
Yeah?
We're going to be using raspberries, strawberries, grapes, and that's it. But we're not going to be using raspberries that you do. We're going to be using raspberries as in the fruit.
The fruit. Freeze.
Get what I mean?
Freeze.
Strawberries, raspberries. Nev, can I finish now, yeah?
Okay.
Sealable bag and a teaspoon. Oh, and some bread so you can dip your... into your jam.
Okay, so what you have to do first, if you have to put in some honey. Nev, make the bee sound, please.
So how many teaspoons, Rhiannon?
Two.
That's two tablespoons. Four teaspoons.
Sticky. Oh, yeah. Sticky. Mm.
Yum, yum.
Lena, I'll wait for you. One. Come on, Rhiannon. Two.
Just get in there.
One.
Nev!
Yum yum! sticky!
Ooh. Once you've done, put our honey, we put a handful of each of our fruits in. So.
Ugh. It might be a bit sticky if you spilt some of the honey.
Jam, please!
Which Nev?
Nev!
Wait, we're doing it!
We're doing it!
Groovy!
Oh, you know what we forgot?
What?
Before we're supposed to do that, we're supposed to put a squirt of lemon juice in.
Oops.
So,
sour.
Just quickly add your squirt of lemon juice in.
Now, don't do too much, okay? Because if you do
square.
Too much, then it won't taste very nice.
Can I have it? Thank you. And just a little.
Then, you mash it all up. But
Mash!
But remember to.
Jam.
Seal your bag.
Okay.
All right, so help me, Nev. Nev, come and end you. Nevi's coming out of the bag.
Nev! Help me! Nev, help me, please. Can you help
Jam,
me?
Please.
Nev!
Go! Yay!
Stop it!
Stop!
It's finished!
Jam! I win!
There's none left in the bag.
What do you were supposed to do after that?
Well, you were supposed to put it in a bowl. Well, Rhiannon's got none left to put in a bowl, so I'm going to put mine in my bowl.
Nev!
open the bag. Okay, now.
Jam, please.
Okay. So, if you missed any of that, or need to like get the instructions, because I went a bit pear-shaped or jam-shaped.
Pears, please.
No.
Pears, please.
How about jam-shaped? Yeah,
jam.
It went a bit jam-shaped. So if you want to see any of that again, like Nev going, hyper, then just click onto the small website and have a jam-tastic time.
Now, dunk your bread. Do you want some, Nev?
Yum, yum. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm feeling the food thing this morning. What are you doing?
I'm getting excited.
What about?
I'm doing the barrel with excitement.
Really?
Yeah, because we're going on holiday.
Oh, holiday. I forgot about that. Is that why we're dressed like tourists?
Yes. Right. We're going to Holland, which is
Holland.
Going to be great.
Isn't
you can
that
buy
source?
Me bunches of tulips and
it's more
we
like...
can pedal along by the canals and do other stuff about Holland.
What, buy clogs?
Yes.
Think of buy clogs.
That'd be brilliant. And to make sure our bags don't get muddled up,
yeah.
I have had a genius idea. What I've done is put a big cross on ours, so that way we know it's ours, don't we?
Good idea. But everyone's done it as well, look. See, so that doesn't really help,
oh,
does it?
Oh, no, oops. Barney.
What?
Well, you know what this means now, don't you?
What does it mean?
Well, our luggage, it's lost properly.
Can I just say something before we go any further?
Yes.
We were talking about a nice little theme tune for that Lost Properly bit. And
oh,
Kirst
yeah.
had an idea. Have a listen to this.
I think I am the believer. I must be lost properly.
That's me, isn't it?
You don't like that?
Properly lost.
I think I must be lost properly. So, yes, it's time for that.
That's cool, isn't it? Yeah, that's my theme tune that I recorded in there. Thanks for that. Sitting me up completely. So, what we need is to work out which bags are ours. It's a good job our chum Nev here works part-time in the airport so we can use
such a good job.
His special X-ray
now,
machine. In fact, would you demo how it works, please, Mr.
B? I'll demo how it goes. Could you put one on there? Oh, when did you escape? Can you put that on the
Mr.
conveyor
Cranky,
belt?
Please.
That gets cranked through by Mr. Cranky, and then when the suitcase goes through the X-ray machine, Nev turns it on. You
Ta-da.
See an image in the screen. You then tell us what you think that is. Of course, it's a ping-pong bat, I think that was.
It is.
So if that's right, I would then take the suitcase out of the back here with some help from my helping people, who also lift suitcases, and it would then go onto a trolley. This game's going to be played by two teams. The team that has the most bags on their side of the trolley wins the game.
Absolutely spot on. Why are you packing a ping-pong bat? Can you play ping-pong?
Actually, no, I can't play ping-pong.
Ping-ping.
Can you play ping-pong?
Ping-pong. Yeah, yeah,
can
I
you?
Win.
Oh.
I didn't know you played table tennis.
Pong ping.
Or pong ping.
Ping pong.
I've got to see this. Can we have a look?
Yeah, yeah. Look. A game. Never mind.
That bear?
Here I am. Lessons, please.
Hiya, Nev. I hear you'd like to learn to play some table tennis.
Yeah, yeah. Wait. Googly, googly, googly. Googly, googly, googly. Ping pong, please.
Oh. Nev, the balls are meant to go on the table, not on your eyes.
Sorry. Googly, googly, googly. Googly, googly.
So, table tennis is a smaller tabletop version of tennis. There's a net running through the middle of the table, and each player has a racket that's called a paddle. And then you hit the ball from one side of the table to the other. Have you ever played tennis, Nev?
Yeah, yeah, tennis time.
Excellent, were you good at it?
Yeah, yeah.
Good, well here's your paddle. And if you're good at tennis, you should be great at this. Nev, we're going to start by teaching you how to play a shot. So I'm going to hit the ball to you, and you have to try and hit it back to me, OK?
Ping pong, please!
OK, here goes. That's great, Nev. Really impressive.
Yeah, yeah! Can't beat me! I win!
You haven't won yet, Nev. You have to score a point before you can win. 11, to be precise. You haven't scored any yet. You can only score a point, Nev, if I miss hitting your shot back, or if I hit a shot that misses the table.
Boring!
Understands?
Yeah, yeah.
So now let's try a rally. I'm going to hit the ball to you, and you have to hit it back to me, and we keep going until someone scores a point.
Okay.
See, Nev, that's what I mean about scoring. You missed hitting the shot back, so a point is scored.
Yeah, yeah! Points, please!
No, Nev, you don't score a point. You missed the ball. I'm the one that scored the point. I'm winning.
Hmm. Oops. No good. Bad sport.
It's okay, Nev. You just need a bit more practice. Why don't we have another game?
A game! Yeah, yeah!
That's the spirit. Let's have another rally and see if you can score some points.
Yeah, yeah! Points, please! Ping pong, please!
Okay, let's get going. Okay, here we go, Nev.
Conch! Beat!
Well, Nev, that was really impressive. You scored a point.
Yeah, yeah! Ping pong points, please! I win!
Well, since that was the end of the session, I guess you do win. Well done, Nev.
I win! I win! Na 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 na! I win!
So you won that then, did you?
I win!
Okay.
Pumping!
As long as we know where we stand, that's all good. He's very good at ping pong.
I'm devastated that we're almost going to miss our flight if we're not careful again, if we don't get a move on with this.
There's a lot of cases to get through there.
4 weeks I've nearly missed my holiday. Well, I have missed my holiday.
Hey, we're in this together. I've missed my holiday too. I should have been basking and getting brown, but no, I've been here getting white with you. No good.
Should we do it?
Let's do it. How long have we got before the flight? Oh, here we go.
Flight number SM1LE will be departing in 2 minutes.
2 minutes! Right, we've got 1 minute to get the cases through.
Come on!
1 minute to get to the whatever it's called. Terminal. Right then, are you ready?
Hold girls. On, girls, you're going first. You're going to be guessing. The thing you're playing for is an amazing smile rucksack each. Here we go. Every week they move their position. You're playing for one of these each, OK? As many as you can guess in your time. Good luck.
Right.
Mr. Cranky.
Mr.
Let's do this. Go, go, go. Oh, his sunglasses are on there. Good work as well, Sam, helping out. Girls, what can you
What's
see?
First one, girls.
Here we go.
Quick.
It's very dark in there, isn't it?
Please. Fix, please.
Did anything come through?
No, not quite yet.
Sorry.
No, press the button.
Hold on.
Broken.
Hang on, stop the machine, stop the machine, stop the machine, stop the machine.
Wait.
Stop the machine.
Looking at me. Let's check the cables, hang on.
Here we go. Go back a second. Sam, you're doing sterling work. You're going to have very big muscles at the end of this. Let's pull some cases back. Ladies, you can't see anything at the moment. What have you done to the machine now?
Okay, now please.
I think it was the cable. I've just plugged it in. Let's have a look.
Right.
Is that working?
Let's have a little look.
You see it? Yeah, it's working. Great.
Excellent.
I pulled the cable.
Okay, we're ready, girls.
Right then.
Off again. Oh,
wow. Coming through. Okay, are all the bags through, guys? Let's try that again.
Ready.
Ready.
Steady. Go, Mr. Cranky. Go, Sam! And an elephant!
Yeah, that's an elephant, that's Ned's.
One right.
Goes on here, girls' trolley.
Oh, there's a
watering can!
Yeah.
Doing it all together, perfect.
A lorry truck!
A lorry.
How did you get a lorry in your case? Yeah, lorry on there, please.
A boxing glove.
Gloves, no.
Yep.
Mittens.
Mittens, you can have that. That's Kirsten's.
A drum kit!
Drum kit!
Yeah,
that's fine. I'm going to practice while we're away.
And your time's up.
Stop!
Okay, that one doesn't go on there, Nathan. That one didn't go on. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4,
okay.
5.
Okay, I can tell Beautiful. You, you scored 5 points,
right,
girls.
Back to
5 points.
Ruby.
You would vacate your seats and let the boys take over now.
Thank
that's
you.
That's it. Sam, you're doing very good work on your own here, hauling all those cases on. Are you set and ready to do it again, you think? Boys, you ready to try and attempt to beat 5?
No, you've got 5 on that one.
Yeah. You ready to do this? That's
yeah,
it.
That
spinning
it.
Around a bit.
Your time was out.
There we go. Oh, hang on. Spin around. That's it. Ready. Steady. Go!
Go!
What
a car.
See?
A car.
That's a car. You can have that one. And the trolley, please, girls. Thank you.
Good work, Sam.
A sand glass thingy.
Yeah, you can have that. Yeah,
a
egg timer.
A sand climber thingy.
It is a sand glass. You can have that.
Oh, a giraffe.
Okay, hang on, let's see if you get it.
Sling it on. Headphones.
Yep, headphones, on it goes. Next.
That's 10 seconds.
Quick!
A paintbrush.
It is a paintbrush, on it goes. One more before the time's up, No, that's, I think that's five each. It's a tiebreak. Where's the rucksack?
Tiebreak situation, BH.
You mean to do it? You're doing it.
Go for it.
It's a tiebreaking question. You've got to shout out your name to answer the question, OK? First person knows the answer, shout out your name. Girls, you want to get by the boys so I can see you? All right, then.
Right.
Just a tiebreak question. You ready? Amsterdam in Holland is famous for its tulips. But what flower is most commonly given in this country as a romantic gesture?
Nathan. Rose!
That was Nathan.
Was first.
Rose.
It is roses. Well done. That means the boys have got it.
Boys have got it. You've got a rucksack. There's another Nathan. Rucksack coming in. Oh! Again.
Coming through.
Another one.
Not
coming
case.
In for you as well.
Thank you very much.
We've got to go anyway. This has been brilliant.
Yeah,
I think
on,
we might be about to miss our flight. So we'll see you when we get
we'll
back.
We'll see you later, yeah.
Excellent. See you.
Oh, hang on, it's not going through. Hang on, hang
are
on.
You managing
it's beeping.
Quickly?
Why is it beeping? I've got
the
my cage.
The flight's going to go soon.
Oh, no, come on. Oh, got...
Who's designed this?
Oh, why is it beeping? Oh, no.
Have you got anything metal on you?
I've got my keys.
What have you... Oh. What have you brought them for?
Just in case I wanted to sing some songs, I've got all the keys that we can sing them in.
Barney. Every week we try and go away. Every week you numpty it up for me, mess up my holiday. What do you suggest we do now?
Well, I haven't read the script, so I'm going to go over here.
I'm going to have to watch Even Stevens. Oh, Nev, don't you just hate it when your best friend starts a new relationship? You kind of feel a little bit left out, don't you?
Oh, never mind.
Oh, you're not the deepest, most emotional of bears, are you? Unless you think about jam, actually.
Oh, jam.
What are you doing back there? What? Are you getting on with your painting? Stop jam. This a second! Stop this! Lose it! No time to think about jam. We're about to play quick on the draw here.
Oops.
In the studio with the guys here, boys v girls. The prize is... I'm going to take that away from you, Nev, just for a second. You'll get your very own Nev painting each. Now, I know that doesn't look like much at the moment, but worse things have made it big in the art world, haven't they? So that could be worth something in the future. You never know. So you'll get a painting each, provided you answer the most, well, guess the most from my drawing as we play Click on the Draw. How are you feeling about that? Confident? Nervous?
Confident that we'll lose.
Confident that you'll lose? Now, this is an interesting scenario. Why would you feel confident? You're not doing Barney's reverse technique, are you? Are you not very good at guessing stuff?
Yeah.
Oh, you are?
No.
Oh. Are you quite indecisive?
Yep.
Are you sure?
No. No, do.
Hey! Girls, how are you feeling about it?
Very confident. I know it will be
OK, well, I'm doing the drawing. Now, I will be spectacularly bad on an even level, so there'll be no cheating at all. OK, we're ready and set to do this. I'm going to head over here and assume the position. Girls, you are going first because on the show last week, girls lost. I've got my little list of things here. Are we ready? 90 seconds for the girls, shouting out when they know the answer, starting from now.
Tree.
A palm tree.
Yes. Okay, next one.
Flower. Grapes.
Yes. Oh, where's my rubber gone? There it is. Oh, this is... got a
watering can.
No.
An axe. A hammer.
Yes. Ewee. Oh right, this one. Oh, that's a bit wonky, but
a doll.
No, and then. In it would
a
go.
Washing machine.
Yes! Right, just maybe got time to do.
Piano.
No. Uh-oh, final few seconds.
A mouth, a nose, a face, a
no! Someone's
a mouth! A mouth!
No! It was the teeth! I was trying to show you the teeth there. Okay, so that means you got four girls, which isn't bad. I think I was going kind of steadily there, boys. Feeling happy or not happy about that?
First.
Can't work you out, Nathan. Right, are we ready? You've got four to beat. 90 seconds starting from now.
A ball. Oh. A foot.
Yes. Good work. Oh, how am I going to draw this?
An apple. Fish.
That's a bit arty, actually, with what I've done.
An apple.
No. An orange.
Fruit.
No, it's quite hard to draw.
A ladybird.
You get. Oh gosh, I don't know how to do this.
Bubbles.
Yes. Brilliant. Oh, now this would be delicious. Oh, I've got a clue there. I'm doing a Barney Harwood.
Banana.
Sorry.
A boat.
A bath. Something in a frying pan, I don't know.
It's on a
pie.
Yes!
A volcano.
A lamp.
Yes! How is he knowing this? Oh no, how do you do this?
A sausage. Glasses?
No.
X-ray vision glasses.
Any idea what that is? Final few seconds.
Someone with a big chin.
That was someone with a big chin. No, it was actually a mask. A mask. Hard luck. So the final scores are for all. For all.
Again.
So that means it's a draw so far.
Cool.
What am I going to do now? What shall I do? Hold on. I know what to do. Hang on. I'm going to flip the coin for it. Here we go. Boys v girls, because you've drawn four each. Wherever this lands, that's who gets the pictures. OK, whichever side it lands on. Boys on one side, girls on the other. Give it a spin. Girls!
Yay!
Spot on, which means that the picture there, you'll get. Oh. It's Nev in a big bag of jam there. It's very, very cute. We'll sort you out with one of those each as well. Hard luck, boys. You didn't think you might be going to lose there. Hold on to that, ladies. Do you know where Barney is? He usually quite likes to join in this time.
No, no.
Weird. I wonder where he is. What on earth? Barney Harwood, what are you doing?
Hiya, Kirst.
What's going on?
I'm in space.
Right. Right, and why are you in space? Why are we in space?
I thought we could do the show from up here.
Right. Okay.
We can call it Smile Trek.
Right. Why are you doing the?
Because that's how they breathe.
Who is this? Sorry.
Yeah, Smile Trek, right? Smile Trek, and you can be my number two.
Stop everything! Hang on a second. A, I would not want to dress up like a numpty like that. And B, I'm not anybody's number two. You
smell like it.
How dare you? This is actually quite a good camera trick. We call this CSO. Wow. Can you see that? It's green screen, or you can do it in blue screen, as long as it doesn't match with anything you're wearing. So I'm all in blue. I'd completely vanish, actually, if it was blue screen, wouldn't I?
Yeah.
And it means you can just monkey around with a picture behind. In fact, can I have a remote control? Here we go. Let's play with this, Barney. Here we go. I'm going to do that.
Oh, great. Steering wheel, please.
Go on, do it. Isn't it cool? You can just change the pictures on the background. And let's change them again, I reckon. Now, hang on. I'm going to change again.
Go on, then. On it.
What we got for you now?
It's a mole. I always knew there was one in this establishment.
Your costume's coming off as you're doing it.
I know. I can't help it. It's got Velcro on it. Or some other sticking material.
Absolutely spot on. So you can just play around with that, you see.
It's good, isn't it?
There's a bit of TV trickery and magic for you. Don't do that.
Coochie.
He's messing around with that. We'll keep playing with this. You watch Even Stevens. What's next?
Have you got a roller coaster one? I love them. I'll skip that. That's not a real foam party.
Have you been to one?
No. But I know, because I have friends in the business who tell me.
You don't have any friends in this business.
I'm about to lose three more. Do you know why?
Why?
We're going to win like big
fans. Oh, no, you're not. It's boys be girls.
I haven't finished then.
Oh, really?
No, yeah.
Oh, you're going to threaten me a bit more?
No, go on, sit down.
I've come back for a bit more threatening, menacing activity. What have you got to say? Come on.
Yeah, well. Well, yeah.
Brilliant. Genius.
Let's meet the boys.
Oh, you're going to meet the boys, are you?
Yeah.
You
gonna... There's a camera shot just there. It's offered up for us. How you doing, fella?
I'm all right.
You're Nathan. Tell me about yourself.
I like skateboarding, playing my guitar to songs like Green Day and stuff like that.
Nice.
And I like doing any stunts, just stuff like that.
You do your own stunts?
Kind of, yeah.
With of course, somebody supervising. You don't go flying over sofas.
Yeah, like some of my friends.
OK, well, that's all good. This is where the disclaimer comes in. Dear ladies and gentlemen, please do not try to jump over your house roof and land the other side safely without somebody watching. OK, Jack.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm fine.
Tell me about yourself.
Like, I'm similar to Nathan, but, like, I like skateboarding and music and stuff.
OK.
I like listening to my MP3 and stuff.
Cool. And what's the meow thing? What's this? These are our badges. This is our team name today.
What? So meow?
We're called Meow, yes.
It's a bit random.
It's a bit random, so you like it? it's as good as any reason, really. We've got a random name. We are Meow. Stick your badges on. We are team... Meow.
You are team random, no doubt about that. Very random this morning. Oh. Girls, you're not random at all, are you?
Just a little bit.
They made that noise then. We've got Marina and we've got Kezia. Tell me about yourselves.
Well, we love acting, singing, dancing,
shopping, texting,
expressing ourselves.
And generally having fun.
And particularly gunching boys.
Oh,
especially those ones.
Really, that's one of your hobbies, is it? Excellent. Well, maybe we'll get to see a demonstration of that particular hobby in action this morning. That'd be marvellous. What are we calling ourselves?
The drama queen.
We almost don't need badges, because look at those.
Oh, yes.
Glittering tops. I think you should keep those on.
Put in my wardrobe.
The badge that you've made here. Thanks very much. I'll pop that there. OK, so, playing for a prize this morning.
Oh, now, can we just
say... money can't buy.
We are the most jealous we've ever been of this prize. Take a look in there. You are playing today for two tickets each to the premiere of The Simpsons at the Dome on the 25th of July. This is red carpet stuff. You're also going to get all the goodies as well that come with it, including an iPod case and a stress donut.
Yeah, I like the sound of stress donut. So, of course, that's for the winners. As ever, the losers end up being pied with gunge. And my washing machine is fed up.
Cracking shot. If only that was a mud pie.
My washer is fed up of having to wash gungy clothes every week, so I really don't want to end up in there this week.
Well, you just set it up, really, haven't you? Are we doing the old reverse psychology this week? We're going
to
lose.
They seemed to be earlier, yeah.
We're going
to
lose, yeah.
We're confident in us losing.
Yeah, we're confident in losing. We're not going to win.
We'll see. We're going to start off by playing Bear Pairs right here in the studio. Girls lost last week, unfortunately. So that means we're going first this week. We've got the right mentality on the go. We're feeling good about this. We're not using reverse psychology. We're going to win.
I'm going to get up and show you how to play the game. It's Bear Pairs. It's the same
as you play... Thanks for telling us you were going to get up.
Well, you know, just so you know what's happening. It was more for the camera guys. All right, then. This here, we've got a board numbered 1 to 16. OK? All you can do is shout out some numbers. I'm going to turn over. Let's say, for example, you shout number...
2.
2. I'll roll it over. You've got Nev in a spaceman's costume. Shout another number out.
5.
Number 5, which is this way. You've got your first pair. Well done.
At the moment, we're quite scuppered for seeing that anywhere. I don't know where...
There's a monitor just there. We can stick it on that TV.
OK, there. OK,
so you're looking there. It's all being sorted out. You'll be fine.
Ready?
Well, that's the idea of the game.
There you go.
Are you ready to play?
It's much better, isn't it?
Now, listen, you're going to get a point for each pair that you get, and then the team with the most points at the end of the game wins 1 point for their team. Does that make sense?
Yes.
OK, then. So, girls, you're going first. You ready? Time starts now.
2 and 3.
2 and 3. No. I gave you a bit of a clue about this one. There you go. 2 and 5. 2 and 5. There you go. First pair.
Oh, good one.
6 and 11.
6, 11. No, that's not a match.
4 and 6.
4 and 6. That's not a match.
11 and 4.
11 and 4. Another pair.
Yee-haw! Riba!
3 and 12.
3 and 12. That's 12. There it is.
Just under 30 seconds left.
No.
16 and 6.
Yeah, well done.
Wow,
three pairs.
3 and 7.
3,
Seven. Yes, four Wait. Pairs.
Ten and one.
Ten. One. No, that's not a pair.
14 and eight.
14 and eight. Nope, no pair.
14 and one.
14 and one. That's a pair.
Seconds.
Well done.
10 and 12.
10 and 12. Just on the time as the buzzer goes. No, eight. That's not a pair.
That's a very so that
good
effort.
Is that four pairs?
One, two, three, four, five pairs.
Five pairs. Five
points
pairs.
You've scored. I like that. Good work, ladies. Happy with that.
Do you want to swap over?
Yeah, I think yeah. We should, actually. You get set with your team.
That's
there.
Vicky, by the way. She sorts all the stuff out for us.
Right.
She loves this.
All of us ready to do this, because it would be too You're simple if we had the same
Cheers,
board.
Babe.
They'd all know where everything was, wouldn't they?
Mm.
You ready to go?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're ready. We can see it from here. You ready, guys?
Don't get them.
Okay.
I've always wanted to be a game show host. This is like the real deal, isn't it?
Yeah. You've got the right dress on today as well. Ready?
You set?
Yep. Time starts now.
One and seven.
One. And seven. No.
3 and 11.
It's stuck. Three and what?
11.
11. No.
8 and 6.
6 and 8. No.
2 and 11.
Who and what?
2 and 11.
2 and 11. Yes.
Well done.
To Matt.
16 and 9.
16 and 9. Yes.
Yes. Well played. 2 pairs.
4 and 13.
4 and 13. No.
1 and 13.
1 and 13. Yes.
Yes. Well done.
5 and 12.
5. Oh, that's a stiff one. And 12.
Mexican hat.
No.
12 and 15.
12 and 15. No.
So we got a total of 3 pairs. You got a total of 5 pairs. Let's go over to our scoreboard.
It's not exactly what they can dance
and
on.
Find out what's happening.
Well, at the moment, it's the drama queens who are taking all the applause. They race into a 1-0 lead. Nev, what do you think of the situation?
Jam, please!
Jam for everybody! Now it's back to Barney and Kirsten in the studio!
OK, we are now over here to play what I'm very excited about, a live version of Ducky Bounce. This is round two this week. We've got the bath filled with some lovely bubbles there, but that's not what it's about, really, is it, Barn?
It's not, no. The idea is to hit ducks over the bubbles and get them into this net here. It's a bit like the game on the computer, except this one works. What's going to happen is we're going to have one player there with a racket, one player there with a bucket of ducks.
Okay. Kezia, you are chucking the ducks. It's then Marina's job to try and bounce them using that oversized racket into the net here. Everyone you get is worth a point. Are you set and ready to do this?
Be careful on there as well.
You've got a minute to try and do it. Please don't knock us out with ducks. It's quite a dangerous game, this. Your minute starts now. Let's play Ducky Bounce. Whoa! See what we mean?
Hey. I could go. Ooh. Unlucky.
Bit gentler, I reckon.
Good shot. Ooh. Whoa! Flipping, eh?
She's
hey, no throwing it in. It's got to go on the racket.
Whoa! Oh, yes,
right,
that's
you can have that one.
One. Oh, nearly.
That's the one, that's the one. You're sort of guiding it in with the racket.
Just a bit gentler, I reckon, again. Oh, I found
Come on,
Don't worry
Marina.
About that crying in the background.
Oh,
just
set. This is a classic case of girl throwing and hitting.
A little bit, yeah.
Come on,
You're doing well, you're doing well.
Oh, that was
Ish. Oh. That's it, you're getting the hang of it now, you're getting the hang of it.
Oh.
You've got 7 seconds left, 7 seconds.
Quickly.
Quick, one more. Oh, so close, so close. Quick, if in doubt, throw two. And your time is up.
Oh, that's a mini one.
Unlucky.
Some of those have gone in the neighbour's garden.
They are.
You have to go knock on, saying about duck back. So let's do the grand count then.
One.
Wow.
Oh yeah.
You're happy with that? I'll keep him safe, I reckon. So boys have to have a little crack at this game.
Oh,
got enough ducks? Do you reckon? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
got a whole bucket.
There's another bucket,
there's a whole
full.
Bucket. Excellent.
Who's batting? Well, who's throwing?
I'm batting.
That's it. Come out of the way now. That's it.
You want to use that one?
Tell you what, why don't you just have a rest, sit down over there, girls, chill out a second while the boys do their thing. How are you feeling about this game? I'm interested to act now with your randomness.
Careful,
I want
now.
To ask about it. Confident or not?
Now we're going to lose.
still doing the reverse psychology.
It's gonna work.
Freaking me out, you boys, this morning.
Thank you.
1 minute on Ducky Bounce. Start now!
See? It's working. It's working.
Much more gentle. That wasn't quite in, that went under.
Gotta go over. You got the right idea, though, there, fellas. Much more of a technical approach here. Rather than the girls just smacking it.
Oh, it's purely unlucky that they're not going in, because you are way very
close.
Watch
your step on here as well, you're right on the edge of that step.
Not quite. Oh,
well,
that.
I'll curse no brain. Oh! It's not in.
I'm catching lots, do they count?
No. How are we doing for time, Kirst?
We've got just under 30 seconds left.
Oh, you're so close. Oh!
If it was me catching them, you'd be up to five now.
Oh, come on! Just one more. Oh. You've got 15 seconds left. Yes, we've got one in there. One more of them, you've won it, fellas. I'll have that one. Yes, two in there. Well done. Can we get another one in the last second? You've got 3 seconds left. 3 seconds. Go. Oh, and 1 second left. Can we make it in? No, unlucky.
Still.
Let's do the counts.
Yeah, do the count. We can't count that one up there because it didn't actually go in.
It didn't actually go in, but this one did. So we've got one.
Missed.
Two. Which means we win. Do we technically win, though? Because anything could happen in this show. Let's go to the scoreboard, shall we?
Well, we should find out.
Well, it's Meow that are looking like the cats that got the cream. They might not be able to pair those bears, but they sure can bounce those ducks. Nev, how did you feel when you saw them flying through the air?
Duckies! Poor duckies!
No, they had fun, I think, and so did the boys. They pull claw it back, and now it's one all. Let's go back to Barney and Kirsten in the studio.
Yeah.
Did you see the spin?
Look at the spin on that.
Go on, Sam. Amazing. I like that a lot. So one all.
One all to play for. And this is the pivotal point of the show. This is where things start to change, because Jambuster always has the most points available.
Okay.
And the boys are always really good at it. But then again, we've had a few girls who've got, like, top scores, so anything could happen at this point.
We have to go first, because...
Because you are what? Lost.
Because we're girls.
No, no, what's the reason you have to go first?
Because we're losers.
Because you're losers, that's
losers.
It. Yes.
Marina, are you set and ready?
Yeah.
Feeling confident?
Yeah.
Wriggle those fingers, warm them up. That's it. Beautiful! Let's jambust!
Does wriggling really warm your fingers up?
Hold on, we haven't seen the computer yet. Stop a second, we can't see.
There we go. Let's stop the game and start again, though.
Stop.
And we've got it now in the monitor, which is all good. Ready?
We're ready. Are you ready? Let's jambust!
Love this tune. You can imagine it,
Jason. I don't mind that for an effort. Your final point, or points?
Probably not.
47.
We've got 47 points to beat. I'm going to move the monitor a little bit over here just because we've got a camera in the way, just so the boys can see it.
Okay,
there we go. Can you see that, fellas?
Yeah.
Happy? Beautiful. Right then. Your time starts when Kirsten goes. Do it. Oh, what a great shot, mate. Well played. Well played. Seagull's important,
Get the seagull.
Well played.
Not still.
You're coming for a mud pie soon, I reckon. How many have you got right so far?
You can bounce that.
Oh, unlucky. It was a good shot. One more. 128 points.
No, don't.
Go on, son.
We're hard.
So there you go. 2-1.
Unlucky.
Is it, though? Should we check
We have to confirm these things officially, of course, so let's go over to our spinny scoreboard person.
Well, it looks like the boys picked up their diploma in jam busting from the University of Skills. They race into a 2-1 lead. But remember, it can all change in quick on the draw, can't it, Nev?
Help!
Yes, I'm sure the teams will help themselves to as many points as they can. Quite right. Now back to Barney and Kirsten in the studio.
You missed his spin again at the end. That was brilliant. Lads, because you won that game, you got yourself some T-shirts. Good throw. Well played. There you go. Look, they've been eyeing for you and everything.
Thanks.
They're both for you. And we've got the point, which means 2-1 officially now. So we should do some quick on the draw, shouldn't we?
They would be perfect for wearing to the premiere, wouldn't they?
They would, actually, yeah.
Bright yellow T-shirts, but you won't be going.
Oh, is that what
you're saying? They're going to have the T-shirts to wear
there. Exactly,
what,
yeah.
What would you wear, girls? Sparkly dresses, do you think, maybe?
I'd go dress as a giant sausage.
Would you? You would as well. Oh, that's going straight on, that T-shirt. Wowzers.
That's where you get that lovely crackle as your microphone's getting dragged over the T-shirt. That's it. How does that sound? We're all good.
So, final round.
I know this.
Lots of points up for grabs. It's quick on the draw. And I'm going to be drawing for the girls. Barney, you're going to be drawing for your team.
Word.
I'm going to be going first. Are you ready to do this? Of course, you've already played this a little bit earlier on, so you've had a bit of a practice at it.
I'm going to head over, Barney.
Why are you saying that? Is that for cameras as well?
Yeah, I'm just letting them know that I'm on the move.
OK, got it.
Right, OK, I've got to just look at this. Oh, OK. Girls, are you ready?
Yeah.
90 seconds, starting now.
A lamb.
A volcano.
A mountain.
Come on.
A girl in a dress.
A girl.
A skirt.
Yes.
Same thing, skirt and a dress. You should do an art show, Kirsten.
A paintbrush.
A pen.
A pencil.
Yes.
A banana. A moon.
Yes. Oh, no, how on earth am I...
I'd have drawn a moon differently.
A truck.
A lorry.
Yes. No.
Are you stuck?
Stuff now.
What have you got, rhinoceros or something?
A horse.
A dog.
A cow.
A cat. A cow.
No, cows have four legs.
A dog. A zebra.
Yes.
Well done.
Oh, how do you do this? Oh, I know. Hang on. Oh, gosh. I don't know how to do this.
That's what makes it fun.
This is rock hard. This is like a big cheat, you guys. Right. Oh, no.
A bird.
No.
Salt and pepper shaker.
Yes!
Hang on, that was
yes!
after the buzzer.
Right on the end.
No.
They're saying that they're getting that. Well done, that's right at the end. That's what it was. Oh, high fives, come on.
High five,
I'm loving that.
High ten. Right then.
7-2 at this point. I'm quite excited. That's a good one. I thought, how did you do with pepper? I got so excited, I've developed a stutter.
You should have put pea in.
What's wrong with doing it? You could do a vegetable. A pepper vegetable. And for a salt, I don't know what you would do for that. I don't know. Right then. I'm not using that. Are you left-handed?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
How did you not know that? All the years we've worked together.
That explains a few things. Right, what am I on here? I'm on round four. There we go. OK. I'm ready.
Good luck, boys.
Fellas, you ready, yeah?
Yep.
90 seconds starts. I guess it starts now.
A hand?
Yep, hand. We can have that. Well done.
A hat?
Nev.
A bear?
Yep, bet. Oh my goodness.
An egg. A TV.
A helmet.
Yep, helmet, well done.
How many is that? Three?
A circle. A fried egg. Toilet seat.
What else do I do here? I can give you a clue by doing this.
Barney.
An orange.
A donut?
Yes, well done.
Wow.
That's just great.
That's four.
It's not green, Barney, you want black.
A book? CD player. I don't know. Calculator.
Yeah, calculator. Well done.
Come on, Barney.
It's now a draw.
Stick man. Damn.
20 seconds.
That's all I can draw there, fellas. Ready for this?
Lolly.
A lollipop, yes, well done.
No!
Next one. And you draw this.
An aeroplane.
Yeah, well done. Next one is...
A knee.
A knee. Did you say knee on the buzzer? Did you say knee on the buzzer?
You said knee, did you?
Yeah. No. I think we won anyway, didn't we?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, baby!
Oh no!
They got eighth.
Losers.
They got eighth one.
It's a beautiful thing, isn't it?
You say that.
Losers.
Let's find out what's happening now.
The
final scores from the scoreboard. Do you think?
We have to officially go over there and find out what's going on. Go on, Sam. Give us a swirly.
Well, it's well done to the boys. Both teams drew their hearts out, but the boys have won 9-7. Now it's back to Barney and Kirsten in the studio.
Take a look in here. You're going to be seeing very soon which prize it is you've won. Of course, the boys are now going to the Simpsons premiere at the Dome. How cool is that? Well done, fellas. That also means you've now got the chance to gunge the girls. Would you like to do that, though, or would you just rather have the prize? I mean, you know,
both. It's tough.
Both. All right, follow me over here. We can sort this out for you. Now, we've set a table up for you already. This is where Nespeed is. Sam, do you want to help us out? Come on then, fella. You can stand in the middle. You go in the middle.
Oh, Nathan, Jack on the outside. Take your position.
No, you can have that side
on. Okay, the girls
this
in there.
This is a silk top.
Is it really?
Oh, nice.
It's even better.
Not a silk top. Aim right for the top. You ready?
Oh!
Boys!
I think you're a bit close.
Go for it!
I think you're... Oh!
Look at that. What a great
close.
Shot. Make sure that gets rubbed in there. You want to get down to the top there as well, fellas. Do the old overarm stuff. That's all good. So there you have it. It's the end of Smile for one more week. Oh, you just missed one right in the face. That was a cracker. Have a lovely time. We will see you the same time, same place, right here on BBC Two. Have a lovely week. Bye-bye.
Grandmaster, one big boss, and one huge country.
Yeah!
Two hot presenters.
All right.
Two teams.
Yeah, they barely be scared of us.
And too many excuses.
I need a toilet.
Three bright sparks, three big shots, and three super spies mean three fab shows for you to enjoy.
That's fun, that's unique.
5 times a week at 5 o'clock.
I think you're gonna like this one.
It's got to be Faves at 5. Get it weekdays at 5 on CBBC One.
You get way more CBBC when you press the red button on your remote. CBBC Extra, just press red!
The star DSDs this week are Josh, who gets in a spin when he tries ice skating, 5 girls pulled together as a rowing crew, and Rudy takes the reins in a unique dog sledding challenge.
DSD with CBBC,
weekdays at 8 on CBBC Two.
That's it from us this morning, but switch over now for more from the CBBC channel. It's a practical joke-packed morning with Hyder in the House on right now, followed by Barney and the Prac Patrol. See ya.
Can't get enough of CBeebies? Then here's a new way to fire your little one's imagination with their favourite shows and more. Now on the radio, CBeebies on BBC Seven.
Inking Bee!
The little people.